guys doing?
Great, great. See, you're from Barbados, that's why they have the marijuana plants in the back, so that was nice. Quick question for the ladies. Ladies, question for the ladies only. Ladies, when you're driving, do you see potholes or you just don't give a shit? Right, guys? You ever sitting in that passenger seat, you look up, you see a pothole, it looks like the Grand Canyon? You think she's gonna change lanes, they'll go around, and she's like, all right. And then they have that little giggle, like, I wanna smack the shit out of you. Bring in bumpers 2 blocks back, bitch. Go get it. Hey, have you ever been in a relationship and then you start to have thoughts about how happy you would be if the other person would just die? Right? You've been there, right? Not that you want to be involved or anything, but they got to friggin' go, man. It's like, I'd be in court, the judge be like, Carl, why are you smiling? I don't know, judge, I'm free. So anybody here been pulled over by a cop lately, like get a speeding ticket or anything? Did you get a ticket, ma'am, or you got like a warning? You did get the ticket? Okay. Because women don't normally get tickets, right? Because women, cop comes up to the car, you know, women start crying, right? They whip a titty out. Right, guys? You can't do that, right, guys? Cop comes up to the car, we show a little nut. Right? Now you bringing asses in jail, right? You're in your ball bag, you're sitting in the penitentiary. The true story though, I was driving around New York City and I ran a red light. Right. Okay, I know I ran the light, though, so I'm sitting in my car waiting on this cop, you know. He marches up, you know, with the usual cop attitude. So I'm sitting there and I rolled the window down. Then I looked out and I noticed it was a Chinese cop. So I started laughing. Right? Because I've never seen a Chinese cop before, I swear to God. This guy comes up to my car, he's got the pen, the paper, he's writing up the ticket. I look at him and I go, guess I'll have the shrimp fried rice. So I'm in jail. Eating rice. Yeah, so I'm married. Been married 19 years. Imagine that, 19 years married. Yeah. 19 years and I've never cheated on my wife. Imagine that, 19 years never cheated. And I'll be honest, I'll tell you the truth on how come I've never cheated, right? Because a lot of guys, we don't like to get too emotional about our girlfriends or our wives, right? Because we're men, we try to keep it all in, but I can honestly say that after 19 years, I'm truly and very much still deeply in love with my house. And I swear to God, I love my friggin' house, man. And I am not giving it up. I see women with big breasts and big butts and everything, but you know what? They don't look as good as a finished basement, I'll tell you that. Not even close, man. Don't even try it. Yeah. You know what's weird though? After 19 years, can you believe my wife still gets embarrassed to do sexual stuff with me? That is so weird, but after 19 years, my wife still gets embarrassed, right? I don't get it, right? I have seen every nook and cranny of her body. Why is she still getting embarrassed? Right? My wife will put on a thong and then hide underneath the covers, go, look at me! Right? Because I went in the delivery room, folks. I went in there, right? Did you go in, sir? I went in the I saw my wife push a baby and a turd out all at the same time. Did you guys see that? Man, I thought it was having twins, like, holy shit. I'm like, listen, doc, the squishy baby, that is not my baby. You can call Mari Povich, but I am not the father. You mean like you're sitting on the couch, though, it's all nice and cozy, you're sitting there with the one you love, right? And then you start kissing and necking and messing around, I love you, baby. I love you, too. Right? So then you decide to go into the bedroom, right, guys? So you pick her up like Mr. Macho Man. You're gonna take her into the bedroom. And as you go to go into that bedroom, she hits her head in the door. Oh my God! Right? And every guy is thinking, oh my God, I hope she still wants to have sex. Yeah, I can see all that blood and everything, but come on, baby, come on. Oh God, come on, let me get one off before the ambulance gets here. No, you're such a bitch. Hey, you guys had a lot of fun. Thank you very much.
All right, folks, we're going to keep this show popping. A lot of comics to go. Our next comic starts happening from now. Ladies and gentlemen, regular at Stand Up New York Comedy Club in New York City, give it up for Rick Roberts.
How we doing, everybody? Oh man, it's good to be back in Connecticut. I've been on the road a lot, spending a lot of time in airports. Do you find these announcements they have at airports make you feel like you're about 6 years old?
Please do not accept any luggage from strangers.
Has this been a problem? People coming up to you and, psst, excuse me, can you take this suitcase on the plane with you? Can you swallow this balloon for me? My friend Pinto will meet you at baggage claim. He's got an eye patch and a scar on his right cheek. You can't miss me.
You betcha.
Of course, they have stupid announcements everywhere. It's not just airports. I call my credit card company. They actually have a recording that goes, please enter your account number. Exactly as it appears on the card. Thanks for the tip. I was going to plug the numbers in randomly. How about please enter your telephone number? One digit at a time. Another useful suggestion, huh? Everything's voice activated now, right? You call information, you get the electronic lady. Please state the name of the business you're calling. Marriott Hotel. I'm afraid I didn't get that. Marriott. Was that Mario's Pizza? Marriott. Thank you. Your call is being connected to Krispy Kreme Donuts. The only time you get a live person, he's in India, of course. Right? Because everything's outsourced. You know, you call your computer company for a technical question, you get, thank you for calling Dell Computer Customer Service. My name is Freddie. Come on, your name is Sunjaya, let's face it, okay? So, Freddie, where are you right now? Where I am located? I'm in Cleveland. Cleveland, Ohio. Please hold. Then you hear, meow. You know, eventually, even phone sex is going to be outsourced. Yeah. You're going to call some 900 number. You're going to get, oh, yes, baby. I'm liking it when you touch me down there. This naughty slut needs a good spanking. What is that? You were trying to reach the Dell Computer Customer Service Department? Yes, our numbers are very similar. No, you reached Bang the Bitch from Bangladesh. Please hold. And then you're, meow. I'm telling you, it's, you know, either the Indian guy, the electronic voice. I even have an electronic voice in my car now, because I have a GPS system finally. And when you set it up, they give you a choice. Do you want a male voice or a female voice? I think they should give you more options. Maybe the Jewish mother voice. I told you to turn 2 blocks ago, but God forbid you should ever listen to me. Maybe the porn star voice? Oh, right there, right there. No, you've passed it. Maybe a rapper voice? What's up, dog? Me and my bitch, we got into a fight. In a quarter mile, you got to take a right. Oh man, too much technology, you know? Do you guys get these spam emails for penis enlargement products? Yeah, even women, right? Some of them start off, hey dude, do you remember that conversation we had about your small penis? I'm like, can you narrow it down? Time and place, maybe? This topic comes up a lot. And what idiots out there really think a pill is going to make your dick bigger? I know for a fact it's not going to happen. I've tried 3 different kinds now, and I'm still hung like a Tic Tac. I got a question, guys. Why is the responsibility on us to be bigger, right? Why don't they come out with vagina shrinking pills? Tiny twats. It's like he's popping your cherry every time. That's my time.